The more you know who you are and what you want, the less you let things upset you.
Gypsy, and I have some words of wisdom to bring you much happiness.
I said it before and I'll say it again. Life moves pretty fast. You don't stop and look around once in a while. You could miss it.
I think it's time to try something new.
Roll on.
Trying to keep it creative. Trying to love what I do. Bose Feldman. He's made a lot of locks in the past. We've solved a bunch of them. They're all a bit different, and they're all pretty difficult. No shaking, no banging, no cutting it in half. No external tools, yada, yada, yada. First things first, get the key off the loop. There's some rattling going on. And I know this isn't going to work, but we have to try it anyways. Let's see if the key unlocks the lock. Obviously not. See, when I rock the lock back and forth, you can see this piece of metal on the inside show up. Looks like the piece of metal has a small hole in it as well. Interesting. It's called loophole, and they give you a loop of wire. So my gut instinct tells me we're gonna have to use this. See if it fits anywhere. There's some friction when you put it through the hole here. It's like it's turning something on the inside. By moving the metal wire through, the friction of the wire actually turns that small metal piece on the inside. And this small metal piece has two sides to it, two holes, one small one and one larger. Sometimes drawing it out actually helps me. When you draw something out, it just kind of helps your thought process a little bit. Maybe you'll see something you can't necessarily see on the outside, but you can start imagining what it might look like on the inside. I know there's a shaft here. The shaft here. And a small metal object right here. But how are they connected? Seems like there might be something here. Something on the inside rocking back and forth. Maybe a pin. Interesting. I feel like... Let me draw it out again. What if I have to line up one of the holes with the shaft on the inside? Oh, there's probably a pin in here. And the pin can slide into the larger hole, hopefully releasing the mechanism that allows it to be unlocked. Let's try that. There we go. Got it. It's very satisfying. For good measure, let's make sure we've got the method down and do it one more time. Insert the wire, rotate the small object, line up the hole, flip it over, allow the pin to drop into the hole. Et voila. Conquered. I know this video is a little different. Sometimes even I need to re-inspire myself. We do the same formula over and over and over. Intro, talking head, solve, talking head, outro. Things like that can get a little redundant, especially when you're doing it week after week without a break. It's nice to try something different and do what it is I love doing, which is tell stories. Let me know if you guys enjoyed this video. Leave a like, subscribe if you haven't already, and we'll see you on the next one. Peace.